is News 3 Now at 10.
Good evening to all of you, and thanks for joining us. For a fifth night in a row, temperatures are once again dropping below zero.
We're only about halfway through this cold snap, too, and the coldest weather likely is still on the way. Getting a look outside, plenty of clear skies these last few days, but that lack of cloud cover isn't helping with the bitterly cold weather. Let's go right to meteorologist Dana Fulton on the backyard patio. We've punished her out there to give us our first warm forecast. It's got to be cold out there.
It is. You're right. It is very cold out here right now. I at least have mittens on. I would have a nice big hat if it wouldn't just completely wreck my hair for later on in the show. Overnight last night, I do want to go backwards just a little bit. We had a very, very clear sky and temperatures to start off the morning. Quite cold outside. We dropped to 18 below overnight in Madison, 20 below in the Dells, and 23 below in Lone Rock. Again, that's with a mostly clear sky last night. Tonight, we'll have a partly cloudy sky. So temperatures not expected to drop quite as much. We're at zero in Madison right now with a calm breeze, one in Monroe and Janesville, and already at about five below in Lone Rock. Of course, those wind chills a little lower than our actual temperature, so it does feel cooler than where we're currently at. We have alert days in the forecast through the weekend and through Monday, so we are about halfway through this cold stretch. The only mix up there in the next few days could see some snow chances for late Thursday and Friday. But I think all eyes are kind of on next week when we start to see some closer to average temperatures creeping back in. We'll take a closer look at your full 10 day in just a few minutes.
Bring it on. Dana, thank you. With marijuana legalization on the table as part of Governor Tony Evers' 2021-23 biennial budget proposal, we're asking local agencies how that would impact their jobs. Madeline O'Neill tells us what would change here in Dane County and what would stay the same.
Well, if marijuana is legalized for recreational use, the state would regulate and tax it, but local agencies would be in charge of enforcing policies. So under this proposal, you would have to be 21 to buy it for personal use, and you couldn't have more than 2 ounces. Dane County District Attorney says this wouldn't affect how his office currently charges these possessions, writing in an email to us that his office hasn't charged standalone simple possession of small amounts for some time, adding that, quote, "We have seen many violent incidences, such as armed home invasions, armed robberies, and homicides, which have been connected to the trafficking of marijuana." In another statement, the Madison Police Department says it will, quote, "continue to enforce local, state, and federal laws, prioritizing our efforts on things that most impact safety and quality of life in our community." A Madison Police spokesperson went on to say that any changes in Wisconsin law when it comes to marijuana should only be considered after carefully examining potential impacts and how it's gone in other states. Now, you might remember in November, the Madison Common Council decriminalized marijuana in the city. If you're over 18, you are allowed to buy up to 1 ounce of cannabis. Now, in the state, if it's legalized, it's estimated that it would bring in about $165 million in revenue every year.
Maddie, thank you. New tonight, the city of Madison is receiving a $250,000 state grant to help with the redevelopment of the Westgate Mall site. It closed last year. The grant from the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation will help fund the demolition of the site and prepare it for a mixed-use development. The plan for the site includes a variety of residential and commercial uses that will complement the existing Hy-Vee grocery store next door.
Next at 10, state health officials recorded 681 new COVID cases today. The state's 7-day average of new cases has dropped now to 970. That is the first time the average has fallen below 1,000 cases since early September. DHS officials also confirmed a second case of the more contagious variant. 3% of Wisconsin's population has completed their vaccination series. That means more than 174,000 people have received both doses of the shot. Even though those numbers are down, state health officials say it's no time to let off the gas, especially with the number of new mutations we're seeing. They say keeping the infection rates low to begin with will in turn help prevent further mutations.
The lesson for all of us who are living in Wisconsin is that we need to do all of the things that we know how to do to prevent the spread of all COVID-19. And that's the only way to minimize the community spread of novel variants. It's also the way to...
Land's End is partnering with the Iowa County Health Department to distribute COVID-19 vaccines. The recreation facility at the company's headquarters in Dodgeville is now operating as a vaccination clinic. Iowa County residents who are eligible to receive a shot at this time can contact the County Health Department for an appointment. Starting out, the facility has the capacity to vaccinate 160 people per day. SSM Health says it has now administered 50,000 COVID vaccines throughout southern and central Wisconsin. SSM Health said it's made the vaccines a top priority and has 18 vaccination clinics in our area. They say these sites could produce 20,000 shots a week, but is limited due to the number of doses available.
For the first time ever this week, we decided to close down the scheduling for first doses for the next week or two because of supply limitations, because SSM, just like any other vaccinator in the state, SSM is not getting the number of doses we request.
SSM Health has not had to cancel or reschedule any appointments due to the supply limits.
10% of Americans have rolled up their sleeves in the battle against coronavirus. The CDC is reporting just over 43 million doses of the COVID-19 vaccine have now been administered. Officials at the CDC say the U.S. is averaging roughly 1.5 million doses daily. The former Wisconsin pharmacist accused of intentionally ruining hundreds of doses of the vaccine has pleaded guilty in federal court. In January, prosecutors charged 46-year-old Stephen Brandenburg of Grafton with two counts of attempting to tamper with consumer products. Brandenburg pleaded guilty to both counts today. The admitted conspiracy theorist could face up to 20 years in prison and $500,000 in fines when he's sentenced in June.
It is still early, but it appears the U.S. is experiencing a lighter than usual flu season. So far, the CDC is reporting minimal influenza activity in 2021. However, officials there say it is too early to claim victory over the virus because second waves of the flu sometimes come as late as April. According to the CDC, there are only 155 confirmed cases of flu hospitalizations so far this season. A CDC official says the precautions taken for COVID-19, including less travel, is probably a factor in the drop of flu cases. The Senate will move forward with the second impeachment trial of former President Trump.
In a 56-44 vote, the senators agreed that they have jurisdiction over the case. Natalie Brand reports from Capitol Hill.
House impeachment managers opened former President Donald Trump's second impeachment trial with a video showing scenes from the attack on the Capitol last month, taking senators who are now jurors back to the events of that day.
The president was impeached by the U.S. House of Representatives on January 13th for doing that. If that's not an impeachable offense, then there is no such thing.
Presidents can't inflame insurrection in their final weeks and then walk away like nothing happened.
Attorneys for the former president argued that the trial is unconstitutional because Mr. Trump is no longer in the White House.
This is not just about Donald Trump or any individual. This is about our Constitution and abusing the impeachment power for political gain.
Day one wrapped with a majority of senators voting to move forward.
On this vote, the ayes are 56, the nays are 44. The Senate shall proceed with the trial.
Six Senate Republicans joined with Democrats. One of those GOP senators was Louisiana's Bill Cassidy.
President Trump's team were disorganized. They did everything they could but to talk about the question at hand. And when they talked about it, they kind of glided over it, almost as if they were embarrassed of their arguments.
Sources familiar with Mr. Trump's reaction to Tuesday's proceedings described the former president as angry at his lawyer's lackluster performances. Natalie Brand, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
Opening arguments are slated to start at noon on Wednesday. Each side will have up to 16 hours to make their case.
More than 200 people have now been charged with federal crimes in connection to the riots at the Capitol. Investigators have used videos and photographs from the riot to identify participants. In many cases, tipsters have also helped them ID people who stormed the Capitol. President Biden making a stop in Wisconsin next week. On Tuesday, he will be taking part in a town hall in Milwaukee with CNN's Anderson Cooper. That'll happen at the Pabst Theater, 7 o'clock. It'll be the president's first visit to Wisconsin since taking office.
New information tonight. One of the five people shot inside a Minnesota health clinic this morning has died. Three of the victims remain in critical condition this evening, and one was discharged from a hospital. This all happened at the Alina Clinic in Buffalo, which is about 40 miles northwest of Minneapolis. The alleged shooter was arrested and identified as 67-year-old Gregory Paul Ulrich. Wright County Sheriff Sean Derringer said Ulrich was well known to authorities before this attack. Also new tonight, the New York trial for recording artist R. Kelly has been pushed back again because of coronavirus concerns. Kelly faces racketeering and sex trafficking charges connected to six alleged victims, including three minors in the federal case. He has pleaded not guilty to all charges. The trial is now slated to begin in August instead of April. Kelly also faces federal and state criminal cases for similar charges in Chicago.
Legendary football coach Marty Schottenheimer has died after lengthy battle with Alzheimer's disease. The NFL expressing its condolences on Twitter, saying they mourn the loss. Schottenheimer coached the Kansas City Chiefs, Cleveland Browns, as well as San Diego and Washington. He led those four teams to 200 regular season victories over more than two decades. Marty Schottenheimer was 77 years old. And still ahead of 10, a bitterly cold time. The Brewers today reminding us spring is right around the corner. Plus a local...
President's Day means more savings at the Brothers Main President's Day Super Sale. Get in right now for the sale of the season with more savings on more brands like Whirlpool, Maytag, KitchenAid, and Amana. We've got a lot more satisfaction for you at Main, like up to 18-month 0% financing and free delivery to make life a little easier. Hey, there's more home satisfaction at the More Store. The President's Day Super Sale. More selection, more savings, and more satisfaction today at the Brothers Main, your local store for more since 1938.
Dear all-wheel drive, I'm your new co-pilot, Camry. Let's show the road what we've got. Snowy streets, we're coming for you. Icy grips, we're holding tight. Wintry mix, meh. Safety's the name of our game. Steady, Camry all-wheel drive.
President's Day deals are on. Get 0.9% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2021 Camry. Hurry in. Find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Ready to move on from workouts like this? Now through February 11th, join Planet Fitness for no enrollment, $10 a month, no commitment. With all this variety, you can move it in our clean and spacious clubs. And use the crowd meter in our app for the best time to visit, so you can work out with plenty of room to move. America, your fitness is essential. Join for no enrollment, $10 a month, no commitment. Deal ends February 11th.
Five Madison area locations. Sign up for $10 a month. Stop in today.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection, a name you can trust when service is a must.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection is here 24 hours a day.
7 days a week for all your residential and commercial plumbing services.
From installation, repairs, and maintenance to complete sewer and drain cleaning, we've got you covered.
Visit MononaPFP.com.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection, a name you can trust when service is a must.
This is one of the biggest furniture events of the year, the President's Sale at Slumberland.
Come on.
Slumberland Furniture has the best prices around on all sorts of furniture. And right now at our President's Sale, everything is an additional 25% off our already low price.
This is totally you.
Oh. Yeah, this is the winner.
Well, hello, Slumberland.
Get your look for less at the huge President's Sale at Slumberland.
Wednesday, Dane County's new public health order goes into effect.
We'll break down what it means for gyms and group fitness classes and ask instructors how they're adapting. We'll see you starting at 4:30 on News 3 Now this morning.
Welcome back. Prices at the pump are going up. According to AAA, the average cost for a gallon is now $2.46. That's a 16-cent hike in the last month. The upward trend is likely going to continue for the rest of February. A spokesperson for the travel agency says commuters should expect to a few additional price hikes up to 10 cents per gallon. Well, if you love a cup of Joe in the morning, you could be helping your heart as long as your coffee is black and caffeinated. A new study from the American Heart Association found that drinking one or more cups of black coffee a day was associated with long-term reduced risk of heart failure. Researchers analyzed data from three major studies with a sample size of more than 21,000 Americans. They found that caffeine was consistently associated with a reduction of heart failure risk. The opposite was true for decaf.
My heart should be doing well, Eric. Construction of UW Health's new transplant clinic is getting a big boost today thanks to a very generous donation from a local entrepreneur and philanthropist. Pleasant Roland, who is best known as the founder of Middleton-based American Girl, is donating $10 million to this project. UW Health says her generous gift will support clinical and operational growth of what is already one of the best transplant centers in the country.
It's going to help numerous individuals with transplant needs, their families, and everybody that helps take care of the patients as well. It's a big win for everybody and will be a real milestone for this incredible transplant program.
Roland has made a number of philanthropic gifts to the city, making some of Madison's most educational and cultural landmarks a reality. But this one may also be one of her most personal. In 2012, after living almost 20 years in kidney failure, Roland herself underwent a kidney transplant at University Hospital.
Next at 10, a local senior center is getting a little creative this Valentine's Day. Photojournalist Jim Rader shows us how staff at the Heritage Center in Portage are helping residents feel the love.
I was just wondering if you even wanted to cancel today, but...
Oh, no.
Are you kidding?
It's not so bad. It's good to see my family. I think they look forward to coming, too.
I found a picture of this place. I think it was in England somewhere. And they had built this booth for visiting. And I snapped a picture of it, and I showed it to Paula, who is our marketing coordinator here, and I said, you know, I wonder if this is something that we could do. Paula and I have had fun decorating it for the holidays. We had a Christmas tree up at Christmas, and we've just gone hog wild with balloons for Valentine's Day, and the families are just so appreciative.
So we used to get together every Monday night, and they'd come to my apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And we'd eat together. They'd bring something. So I do miss that. And I'm celebrating 4 years here this month.
Mm-hmm.
So this will be my fourth year here.
This is probably the closest they've been to their families. So at least this way, they can still see their families. Are you excited to see your family today?
Oh, I always am. Mm-hmm.
Always. Yes.
Especially every other Monday when they bring food.
Photojournalist Jim Rader, our thanks to him. Organizers say they actually got the idea from a social media post from England, and so far they've gotten a lot of use out of it.
New tonight, community partners have now raised $70,000 in donations for a 160-acre addition and restoration project at the Pheasant Branch Conservancy. The county acquired the land next to Pheasant Branch Conservancy in 2019, and thanks to the donations and fundraising, restoration work on the expanded conservancy is now moving forward. And finally, you have probably seen a red lobster and maybe even a blue lobster, but the University of New England is introducing us to a yellow lobster. Meet Banana. Its yellow color comes from a pigment in its shell. According to the Lobster Institute at the University of Maine, experts say the odds of catching one are about 1 in 30 million. It was caught at Tennant's Harbor in St. George and donated to the university.
And Dana Fulton joins us again with a look at the forecast.
A very cold forecast as we look ahead through the next several days. We're going to hold on to those alert days in the forecast. Just a friendly reminder, when that's popping up on the screen, means that conditions are going to be quite cold outside. Make sure that we stay extra layered up through the next few days. There is going to be a small chance for some snow as we look ahead to late Thursday and into Friday morning. It doesn't look like it's going to bring a lot of accumulation, but still a little bit of a snow chance building in. Something to shake up the pattern that we've been in. And as we look ahead,
ahead, of course, through the weekend, those wind chills staying below zero. It's a pattern we've been in for quite a while now, and I know I've been telling a lot of folks to try to stay inside if you can, but those of you that do have to work outside or spend long periods of time outside, hopefully you've had some warm coffee in the morning and some warm hot chocolate when you're getting home in the evening, because it has been a cold stretch. Radar right now is quiet. Partly cloudy skies expected for us overnight. We do have wind chill advisories in effect for areas north of the Dells overnight into Wednesday morning, as our temperatures will be dropping below zero and those wind chills will be falling even lower for the areas in central Wisconsin. Overnight, we'll drop to about 6 below as we head into Wednesday afternoon. Variably cloudy skies and cold again with high temperatures in the single digits. For early in the day on Thursday, temperatures will be below zero, and through the afternoon, we'll stay mostly cloudy with that small chance for some light snow developing. Flurries possible in the early afternoon. By the time we get to the evening commute, light snow starting to build in later in the evening. That'll continue till about midnight. This light snow not expected to bring a lot of accumulation, but because any sort of melting agent really won't work with these cold temperatures, it could make roads a little slick early in the day on Friday. This all moves off to the east. Some flurries possible on Friday, but not expecting any more accumulation. And generally, these totals staying well under an inch, so nothing that's really going to take a lot of effort to get cleaned up. But again, just a little bit of light snow on the ground when it's this cold outside can make things slick early in the day on Friday. So we do have alert days in the forecast through the work week and the weekend and to next Monday. Monday is going to start to be our turning point where we get a little bit of a jump up in our temperatures, and those wind chills won't be quite as bitterly cold as we look ahead to next week. But our 6 to 10 day outlook and our 8 to 14 day outlook, still very likely that our temperatures will be trending below average, even as we look at the chance to at least see a small warm up for the middle of next week. Variably cloudy skies tomorrow and still bitterly cold outside with high temperatures in the single digits. Again, today we did hit 10. Tomorrow will be pretty close to that. The same goes for Thursday. So temperature-wise, it's going to feel pretty similar outside. But by Thursday, we have that small chance for some light snow starting to build in later on in the day. That's going to linger to flurries on Friday. Chance for some flurries on Saturday. Saturday and Sunday could see some very cold overnight lows again, with temperatures likely dropping into the teens below zero. Wind chills even colder than that. So those two mornings, Sunday morning and into Monday morning, very, very chilly outside. But by Tuesday, we'll likely start to see the teens above zero again, maybe even the 20s by the middle of the week. So we're going to pull those alert days back in a way as we see a small warming trend. We're still below average for the end of February at that time, but 22 is quite a jump up from seeing a low of 18 below zero where we were at this morning.
Those days when 15 gets us all excited next Tuesday. Dana, thank you. Well, this will get us a little more excited about some warmer weather ahead. Just heading sports and Brewers. They are all packed up for spring training. Who's bat? They're packing just in case he decides to play. That's next in Sports with Zach.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Exciting things call for a drum roll, like this new offer on one of Wisconsin's favorite lotto games. It's Badger 5 with Lightning Ball. During February, there's a 1 in 3 chance that a lightning ball strikes a play. When it does, players get an extra number, which means better odds of winning a prize. Jackpot not included, only in February. This exciting offer from the Wisconsin Lottery is going fast.
With iCare, you can receive up to $1,200 in over-the-counter benefits to buy brand name and generic products. Shop in-store or get the items delivered free from our catalog. Rest easy. iCare is looking out for your health needs.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Ready?
No.
No? Yes, you ready to go to sleep for real?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Guess what? You get two kisses.
Yeah.
Very good. And one more for good luck.
Uh-oh.
Love lower than low prices? Then get more ways to save at Pick and Save, where you can find personalized coupons, weekly deals, and rewards like fuel points. All for prices that are lower than low. On food that's fresher than fresh. Pick and Save. Fresh for everyone.
These deals are amazing.
I know. How do we get them?
Okay, we have to be very subtle about asking, like this.
Like this?
No, like this.
Actually, you don't have to do any of that. Switch and get the Samsung Galaxy S21 5G for free.
Even without the...
You would have gotten it anyway.
Cool.
Get the Samsung Galaxy S21 5G free with no hidden requirements. U.S. Cellular.
It's time for the Great American Sales Event at your local Ford store. Celebrate with FlexBuy. Get 0% APR for 66 months plus 1,000 President's Day cash on top of other offers on select SUVs. With deals on America's best-selling brand, now's a great time to buy. Hurry in or shop online before February 15th. Get FlexBuy in a 2020 Escape with 0% APR for 66 months. And with President's Day cash, get a total $3,000 cash back. Celebrate now during the Great American Sales Event.
We got to shoot better. You know, we're getting really good looks, getting great looks from three, and it's not one person, it's everybody. We're all getting good looks.
It sounds simple, but for the Badger men, shooting hasn't been, especially from three-point range. In four of the last seven games, they've shot 25% or worse from deep in their average, and Micah Potter hasn't really been able to buy a bucket from three-point range. He was 0 for 5 on Saturday. And that didn't sit well with him. So instead of just calling it a night after the Illinois game, he went back to the gym to work on his game for hours.
I can tell you that I was in the gym and I shot after we got back from Illinois until the gun broke. And I'm not exaggerating. So it's that's not because I just shot a billion shots, just because, you know, it is what it is. But I was frustrated after that game because I know I'm a much better shooter than that. It's good to be upset about because it can motivate you for the next game. But it's also not good to dwell on it because, you know, mentally that could take you down a really, you know, long and bad path.
We're less than a week away from the start of spring training, and the Brewers are packing their bags. Well, at least the equipment managers were. The crew loaded up roughly 2,500 baseballs, 1,000 bats, 200 batting helmets, 400 practice jerseys, and of course, Bob Uecker's chair and microphone into the truck and started the drive down to Arizona. Ryan Braun said today that he isn't ready to officially retire, but he's also currently not interested in playing yet either. So the Brewers packed his bat just in case. And in case you haven't been paying attention, the Badger men's and women's hockey teams are playing some really good puck right now. And the leagues have taken notice. Dylan Holloway was named the Big Ten's first star of the week, while Cole Caulfield was tabbed the league's third star. And the women nearly swept the WCHA Player of the Week honors, with Daryl Watts, Grace Bowlby, and Lacey Eden all taking home weekly honors. After winning a state title last season, the goal for the Verona boys hockey team, get back to defend their title. And this year was a crazy one for the Wildcats, but they made it to the sectionals. And standing in their way to a trip to the sectional finals, Sauk Prairie. The Eagles led 1-0, but the Wildcats would explode in the second period. Nate Jurens sends a snipe into the back of the net to tie the game up at 1. And then later in the period, Verona just peppering the net, and Anthony Henrik scores off the rebound. Verona moves on to the sectional finals with a 4-1 win. They'll face Wanakee on Friday with a trip to state on the line. We're back after this.
Hey, Dutch boy, show me Mocha Red.
Okay.
Does it have a smooth, durable finish?
Yes, and it's 50% more stain resistant.
Still talking to Dutch boy?
Dutch boy, show me Sleepy Purple.
Okay.
Oh, would you look at that.
That's better.
He'll still help us paint, right?
With Dutch Boy's high-quality, high-performance paint and Menards-friendly expert service, it's easy to twist off to something great.
You're handier than I thought.
Love, love. Roses and a sweet surprise and gifts that we thought of.
when Cupid comes to call.
Fusion has it all. Modern styling, spacious interior, plenty of power. Even help to inspire confidence. Ford Copilot 360. NHTSA 5-star overall crash rating. 5-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. So while life is full of compromises, Fusion isn't one of them. Get Flex Buy on 2020 Fusion with 0% APR for 66 months. And with President's Day cash, get a total $4,000 cash back.
Whoops. Mute. As I was saying, come celebrate Bob's 30th anniversary at the first virtual Bob Fest. This President's Day weekend, we're celebrating big time online with virtual balloon animal tutorials, printable activities, and the first ever couch concerts. And of course, get Bob's discount on living room, bedrooms, mattresses, and more.
Can you make me a line, please?
Ta-da!
It's a chair.
Join the fun at Bob Fest 2021 in store and virtually at mybobs.com.
Every year, thousands of Wisconsin residents make the difficult choice between eating or heating their home. So please join News 3 now and support a week of warmth, benefiting the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund. 90 cents of every dollar donated is used to help those in crisis. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the need is now greater than ever. Give the gift of warmth. For more information, visit kwwf.org. Week of Warmth, sponsored by Viridian Homes.
Channel 3000 Plus. Watch from your streaming media player or mobile device.
And Dana Fulton's back with a recap of our chilly forecast.
A lot of cold news for us in the weather office right now. We have alert days extending through the rest of the work week this weekend and for Monday. Tonight, there's a wind chill advisory for areas north of the Dells. Temperatures tonight dropping below zero yet again. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll be back close to 10 degrees. For Thursday, we see a light chance for snow developing later in the evening and overnight. Flurries possible for Friday and Saturday. We're back to sunshine for Sunday and Monday. And by the middle of next week, might even see the 20s a few times.
All right, a little something to look forward to. Dana, thanks. Thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 10.
Do something good, be well, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.